Today we're going to test a home salsa recipe to make sure that it's well within a range of pH that is considered safe. Since salsa contains tomatoes with a borderline pH level of 4.2 to 4.8, as well as low acid vegetables such as peppers, onions, garlic, and others, and acids such as lemon juice or vinegar must be added to the product to bring that pH down to a level that is well below 4.6. In fact, with salsa and other acid and acidified foods, it's usually less than 4.2. This allows for a buffer to avoid going above 4.6. This will prevent the growth of Clostridium botulinum, which can produce a deadly toxin. So when foods are thermally processed, such as a jar of salsa, the individual components of the salsa maintain their own pH for a period of time. Eventually, the entire product has the same pH. This varies with the consistency of the product, and after 2 months, the pH should be the same throughout the product. So we will assume that this salsa was made 2 months ago, and the pH should be at an equilibrium throughout the entire product. So to test this, we simply stir. If it hadn't reached an equilibrium, we would have to maybe separate the solids from the liquids or puree the product. Stir it up to get a nice representative sample, and we will take 2 readings. Okay. So the first thing we do is we take our calibrated meter, and as you can see, it's still in calibration mode. So I am going to press measure and bring this into measure mode. Rinse the probe off with water. Dab it dry. And then I put it in and just gently stir until the value stabilizes. This is at 4.10. I'll write that down immediately. Well, it's fresh in my memory. Rinse the probe off. Dab it a bit. And then I'll measure the other sample of salsa from the same jar. And once again, this one is hovering 4.09. That is what it appears it's going to read. So once again, I will write that value down, 4.09. And then I will do a value or an average of the two. And so we end up with basically 4.10. Rinse it. Dry it a little. And then store it with the cap on and read the directions that come with your meter to make sure that you're storing it correctly. I'll shut it off as well. So basically, this salsa is well within the range that is recommended, and we have the meter stored and ready to go to be calibrated for the next time. When home preserving foods, use a tested recipe so you can home can with confidence. The United States Department of Agriculture and land-grant universities such as South Dakota State University and companies that use USDA guidelines are examples of credible sources. Also visit the SDSU Extension iGrow website, igrow.org, for more information on food safety and home food preservation.